Hello everyone, myself Dipali Wadkar, working as assistant professor WIT Solapur. Welcome to this video lecture. Today we will study pulse amplitude modulation. At the end of this video lecture, student will be able to illustrate working of PAM modulator with its waveform, and also student will be able to illustrate working of PAM demodulator with its waveform. Classification of pulse modulation. Pulse modulation classified into two types: analog pulse modulation and digital pulse modulation. Analog pulse modulation is divided into three types depend upon which parameter of the carrier signal changes. So its types: pulse amplitude modulation, pulse width modulation and pulse position modulation. Next, digital pulse modulation, its output is in the form of code, that is in the form of digital signal 1 or 0. So it is divided into two types: pulse code modulation, that is the PCM, and delta modulation. Now, pulse amplitude modulation. In the pulse amplitude modulation, the modulating signal is a continuous time signal. Carrier signal is train of pulses whose amplitude and width is constant. These train of pulses are spaced from each other by time TS. It is called as a sampling period. Okay. So this train of pulses here act as a sampling function. In pulse amplitude modulation, the amplitude of these pulses varies according to the amplitude of continuous time signal. So, depend upon how this amplitude varies, there are two types, that is the double polarity, or it is also called as a bipolar PAM. Here positive as well as negative pulses present, and second, that is the unipolar. So only positive pulses present in a unipolar PAM. Now, types of PAM, there are two types of PAM: natural PAM and flat top PAM. So first, that is the natural PAM. In the natural pulse amplitude modulated signal, that at the starting of carrier pulse, its amplitude is equal to instantaneous amplitude of continuous time signal, and at the rest of this cycle, it follows the amplitude of continuous time signal. Okay. So the top of all these pulses follows the natural shape of continuous time signal. Okay. So it is called as a natural PAM. Now the generation of natural PAM. In this, the continuous time signal x of t, we can say it as a information signal or message signal. This continuous time signal is given to the low pass filter. Low pass filter is used to band limit this continuous time signal. Its frequency is, cutoff frequency is adjusted to FM. So this low pass filter is used here to avoid the aliasing effect. Okay. Now the next block, that is the multiplier. Here the another input to the multiplier, that is the train of pulses. It generates a train of pulses at constant interval. So this train of pulses having the constant amplitude, constant width. These train of pulses spaced from each other by TS. It is called as a sampling period, and its frequency is a sampling frequency FS. This FS is always greater than twice of FM. The multiplier gives the output, which is nothing but PAM, where the amplitude of these pulses or this train of pulses varies according to the amplitude of continuous time signal. Okay. So the information which is contained here, this information is in the amplitude variation of this train of pulses. So this is the circuit arrangement for natural PAM. Here the MOSFET used as a switch. The continuous time signal x of t is given to this MOSFET. The another signal to the MOSFET, that is train of pulses, it is called as a driving function C of t. we can see the PAM signal or output signal across the RL. Okay. So when driving function becomes on goes to the higher value, then this MOSFET act as a closed switch. Okay, it turn on and it act as a closed switch. So at the output, the amplitude of pulses is equal to instantaneous amplitude of continuous time signal. Okay, when the low value of this driving function is given to the gate of this MOSFET, this MOSFET act as a open switch. So the output at that time is a zero. So in this way, we get a pulse amplitude modulated signal across the RL. Now, the detection of this natural PAM. This natural PAM signal is passed through a low pass filter. By using this low pass filter, we can remove the high frequency ripples which are present in a PAM signal. The capacitor which is present in the low pass filter circuit, it will charge during the on pulse, and that capacitor will discharge during the off pulse. So in this way, with the help of charging and discharging voltage of the capacitor, the continuous time signal is obtained at the output of low pass filter. So the PAM signal is demodulated by using the low pass filter. Now next is a flat top PAM. In the flat top PAM, at the starting of pulse, the amplitude of this pulse is equal to instantaneous value of continuous time signal, and for the rest of cycle, this amplitude remains constant. Okay, so here the top of all these pulses remains flat or constant, so it is called as a flat top PAM. It does not follow the natural amplitude of continuous time signal. Now this is the circuit arrangement for the flat top PAM. Here two FETs act as a switch. One is a sampling switch, another is a discharge switch. A continuous time signal x of t is given to this switch. Okay. Pulse is given to the gate G1. At that time, this sampling switch turns on and this capacitor start charging. So this capacitor charges up to the point or up to the amplitude equal to amplitude of instantaneous value of continuous time signal. Okay. After this point, sampling switch and discharge switch, both switch becomes off, and capacitor holds this voltage for one constant time period. Okay. We can say it as a tau. Okay. After, at the end of this pulse, the pulse is get applied to the G2, that is to the discharge switch. So this switch becomes on here, sampling switch is off, and due to this, this capacitor will discharge to zero value. So in this way, we get a flat top PAM signal at the output of this capacitor or across this capacitor. Now, detection of flat top PAM. Here, the PAM flat top PAM signal is applied to the reconstruction filter. This reconstruction filter is again low pass filter whose cutoff frequency is adjusted to FM or greater than FM. Now, it will remove all the high frequency ripples from this PAM signal, and the another signal circuit or another filter here use, this is nothing but equalizer. Okay. So this equalizer is used to remove the aperture effect which is present in a flat top PAM signal. So what is this aperture effect? In flat top PAM spectrum, the high frequency component get attenuated due to one function or due to one transfer function. Okay. So this attenuation or this distortion in amplitude is called as aperture effect. Okay. So these distortions are removed by using one special filter. It is called as a equalizer. Okay. Now this distortion less signal is obtained at the output of equalizer. So this is nothing but continuous time signal, which is recovered from this PAM signal. Now next, advantages of PAM. It has better signal to noise ratio due to increased signal power. All the circuits for PAM modulation as well as demodulations are simple, so its generation and detection is easy. Now the question, what is the effect of noise on PAM signal? Pause the video for a while and think. So this will comes in disadvantages of PAM signal. So as the information contained in the PAM signal is in the form of variation in amplitude, okay, and we know that noise effect is greater in a amplitude of any signal, okay. So there is a effect of noise on PAM which will distorts the PAM signal, okay. Also another disadvantage is that is the aperture effect introduced in the PAM signal, especially in a flat top PAM signal. Now the applications of PAM. So number of Ethernet standards are the examples of PAM applications. In particular 100 base T4 and broad art reach, it uses a 3 level PAM system. Then 1000 base T, it uses level 5 PAM system, and 10G base T use 16 level PAM system. This PAM concept is also used to study of photosynthesis by special instrument, and it is comes in a photobiology. Next, electronics drivers for LED lighting. The PAM system is used or developed to control the light emitting diode, especially for lightning application. So next, in digital television, the North American Advanced Television System Committee standards for a digital television use a form of PAM to broadcast a data which generates a television signal. So these are the references. Thank you.